Camouflage, a Nameless Detective Novel by Bill Pronzini. Narrated by Nick Sullivan. For Dominic Abel. Chapter 1. I said, "You want us to do what?" David Virden showed me his teeth in a lopsided smile. "Find one of my ex-wives," he said again. "The first one."
"Divorced 8 years, you said."
"That's right."
"And you want her located for what reason again?"
"The same reason I had to track down the other two, so I can have the marriage annulled."
Virden looked, sounded, and acted normal enough. Executive with a manufacturing firm in the South Bay. His business card confirmed it. 40 or so, fair-haired, gray-eyed, handsome in a sleek metrosexual way, sitting comfortably in one of the client's chairs across my desk, legs crossed and 1 foot jiggling a little so that his expensive polished loafer threw off little glints of light from the overhead fluorescence. But if there's one absolute truism in the detective business, it's that people's exteriors don't always reflect their interiors. Some of the most attractive ones are like buildings full of dark rooms and the kinds of things that hide in them.
"I haven't seen her since the divorce," he said, "and nobody else seems to have seen her in about 7 years. Of course, she could be dead by now. If that's the case, there won't be any problem."
"Oh, there won't."
"No. Anyhow, we didn't have any trouble finding the other two. They were both pretty cooperative."
"In giving you annulments?"
"That's right. I need the third before I can go ahead, or proof that she's no longer above ground."
"Go ahead with what?"
"Marrying my fiancée, Judith Lopresti, my fourth and, I hope, last wife."
I'd gotten it by this time. A little slow on the uptake these days, but prospective clients who walk in off the street and smack you with a job request you've never encountered before are relatively rare. At least Virden wasn't a head case, the kind with no method to their apparent madness. I said, "Are you Catholic, Mr. Virden?"
"No." "Well, not yet."
"But Judith is."
"Devout. Mass every Sunday, and the Pope can do no wrong."
"And she won't marry you unless you convert. Is that it?"
"That's it. Convert and then have a church-sanctioned wedding. Only I can't convert without the annulments from my ex-wives because the Catholic Church doesn't recognize civil divorce laws."
"Uh-huh."
"You know about that, right? I mean, your name, I figure you must be Catholic. Most Italians are."
"Born and baptized," I said. I didn't add that I was lapsed, for reasons of my own that were none of his business. I happen to believe that religion, like sex between consenting adults, ought to be, and too often isn't these days, strictly a private matter. I also believe in separation of church and state, the golden rule, the true definition of family values, that anybody ought to be able to get married regardless of gender, that no one has the right to distort the truth for any reason, and that people ought to quit trying to shove their beliefs and opinions down the throats of other people. Just another crazy old radical thinker, that's me.
"I've never been religious myself," Virden said, as if he was proud of the fact. "But I'd do anything for Judith. She's a real prize."
He showed me his lopsided smile again and added a wink to it.
"Her father happens to be loaded. I'll be set for life once we're married."
"Nice guy, Virden. Full of compassion and the milk of human kindness." I wondered if he was as upfront about his motives with his devout intended. If not, I hoped for her sake that she knew what kind of man she was taking into her faith and her bed.
He said, "Here's the stuff from the church,"
and passed a small manila envelope across the desk. Inside, paper clipped together, were a 2-page letter from the judicial vicar of the Diocese of San Jose addressed to Roxanne L. McManus at an address in Blodgett.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.